Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we are in the Basilica of Mary Help of Christians in the city of Turin in Italy. This basilica was completed by Don Bosco in 1868. It is from here that Don Bosco spread the devotion to Mary Help of Christians.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today we shall reflect on the virtue of patience. Patience is the capacity to accept or tolerate delay, problems or suffering without becoming annoyed or anxious. It enables us to exercise restraint in the face of delay or provocation without giving into irritation or anger. It makes it possible for us to endure all the wrongs and misfortunes of life without discouragement, but instead with hope and trust in God. Those who are patient do not look for instant solutions, but are prepared to wait, knowing that both they and others need time to grow and to change. They accept the fact that things must unfold at their own pace. All of us encounter frustrations, disappointments, contradictions, privations, sicknesses, and hardships in life. Patience helps us to face them without losing our serenity and without giving in to despair. It is a virtue that everyone is called upon to exercise frequently. In his first letter to the Thessalonians, chapter 5, verse 14, St. Paul exhorts us, saying, "Be patient with everyone." Patience gives us control over anxiety, sadness, despair, and anger. This control is very much needed for the practice of other virtues like love, generosity, and meekness. So, patience is a virtue that helps the practice of all the other virtues. Very little can be achieved in life without patience. Genius, says Michelangelo, is eternal patience. Often we find it difficult to practice patience as it might cause us some suffering. It would be easier for us at that time if we can think of the sufferings of Jesus on the cross and unite our sufferings with the sufferings of Jesus for the salvation of the whole world. It is this that helped people like Saint Alphonsa to be patient and to give meaning to their suffering. She says, "A day on which I have not suffered is a day that is wasted." If there is no suffering in our life, there is nothing for us to unite with the sufferings of Christ. Our Lady is a great model for us in the practice of patience. She would have exercised patience with Joseph when he doubted her. She would have had to be patient during the journey to Bethlehem, during the flight to Egypt. She would have exercised patience with Jesus when he got lost, when he delayed to work the miracle she asked for at Cana, and at other moments in his life. And finally, at the foot of the cross, she would have exercised tremendous patience to restrain herself and to endure all the sufferings that it involved without losing her composure and without losing hope. May our Blessed Mother assist us to grow in the virtue of patience.
Today we shall pray the novena from the altar of the Sacred Heart of Jesus in the Basilica. We shall pray this novena asking the Heavenly Father, through the intercession of Mary, Help of Christians, to heal all those affected by the coronavirus, to support all the health workers and their helpers, and to free the world from COVID-19. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Blessed and praised every moment.
Be the most holy and divine sacrament.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Blessed and praised every moment.
Be the most holy and divine sacrament.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Blessed and praised every moment.
Be the most holy and divine sacrament.
Hail, Holy Queen,
Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To you do we set up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Tremble, most serious advocate, thy eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. Amen.
Mary, help of Christians,
pray for us.
Hail, Holy Queen,
Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, O Virgin, children of Eve. To you do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Tremble, most gracious advocate, thy eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. Amen.
Mary, help of Christians,
pray for us.
Hail, Holy Queen,
Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Tremble, most gracious advocate, thy eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. Amen.
Mary, help of Christians,
pray for us.
Remember,
O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who felt thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession, was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother, to thee I come. Before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of God incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy mercy hear and answer me. Amen.
Prayer for deliverance from the coronavirus. Almighty and eternal God, from whom the whole universe receives energy, existence and life, we come to you to invoke your mercy, because today we are still living the fragility of the human condition in the experience of a new viral epidemic. We believe that it is you who guides the course of human history, and that your love can change our destiny for the better, whatever our human condition may be. This is why we entrust the sick and their families to you, for the Paschal mystery of your Son gives salvation and relief to their body and their spirit. Help each member of society do their job by strengthening the spirit of mutual solidarity. Support doctors and health workers, educators and social workers in the performance of their duties. You who are comfort in fatigue and support in weakness, through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary and of all the holy doctors and healers, keep all evil away from us. Free us from the epidemic that is affecting us, so that we can calmly resume our usual occupations and praise you and thank you with a heart renewed. We trust you and address our plea to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Have the blessing of Mary, help of Christians. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We fly to your patronage,
O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Mary, help of Christians,
pray for us.
O Lord, hear my prayer,
and let my cry come unto you.
The Lord be with you,
and with your spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who by the cooperation of the Holy Spirit did prepare the body and soul of the glorious Virgin Mother Mary to become a worthy dwelling for your Son, granted us, we rejoice in her commemoration, we may, by her loving intercession, be delivered from present evils and from everlasting death. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, descend on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
O help of Christians, my mother be, to thee I pledge my fidelity. Mary, my mother, my guide thou be, with thee and Jesus I'll ever be. Mary, my mother, my guide thou be, with thee and Jesus I'll ever be.